the Excel formulas. So it's a ultimate feature in the Excel. Mostly we are using the Excel formulas. Like whenever need a calculation, some average, count or anything, we are using the calculations within the Excel, right? But whenever you are using the VBA, we need to write a worksheet function. You know, in the Excel, if you are using the formulas, what will happen is it will take unnecessary memories, as well as it will take some time to run the task, as well as it will affect some other way. So that you need to try to avoid the Excel formulas. Instead of that, you can use the worksheet functions. We have it in the Excel VBA. So before that, you should know the basic formulas, how we can implement the basic formulas like sum, average, count, counter, max, minimum, count blank, rank, right, left, proper, upper, lower, length, VLOOKUP, IF ERROR, IF, concatenate, COUNTIF, repeat, COUNTIF, now, today. So here I have listed only the few formulas. Even maybe you can be an expert, but just, you know, walk through everything. That will definitely help to you. So this is the calculations we have done in the Excel spreadsheet. But now we are going to do the same operations in the Excel VBA. So the Excel VBA concept is something different, but you are using the same logics. Let me show you. Sub, I'll create one more new procedure, sub formula. So now I want to use the sum formula from range B3 to C3, sorry. Range D3 to D11, I want to sum the totals. So for that, first you need to declare any of the variables. It can be any names. My where equals worksheet function dot sum of open bracket, and you need to mention the range D3 to D11. It's completed now. Now we can, so using the F8 key, I can display the results 2907. So here also in the Excel formula, it's also displaying the same results, sum of D3 to D11. But using the Excel VBA, there is a lot of advantages out there because of, you know, you can declare the variables as well as you can use at any time. It will not affect the memory, system memories. Usually the Excel formulas will affect the system memories. It will take some more time to, you know, if you're opening the workbook, the Excel formulas needs to be refreshed each and every time. Whenever you are using the Excel VBA, it will not affect your Excel workbooks. Directly, it will get the results. It can be declared the variables. So it's very easy concept like this. So here I have provided the example for sum. Like this, you can use this count, counter, anything, any kind of Excel formula, maximum number of Excel formula can be used in this Excel VBA. Sub counts. So here also I am going to declare counter. Worksheet function dot counter of range D3 to D11. So here the range, you know, I am not mentioning the worksheet or workbooks event, but in your case you need to mention that because of the current active sheet is I have only single sheet. That's the reason I am not mentioning the sheet 1 or sheet 2, some sheet name, something like that. But in your case, it's a good practice. Always needs to mention the worksheet as well as the workbook. You know, workbook is not a mandatory, but please try to mention the sheet's name. Sheets of sheet name or else sheet 1 dot range, something like that. Then only there will be a error-free quotes or else you will see some of the errors. So here you can see counter 9. We got the same results. Exact results using this Excel VBA code. So this is the perfect method for formulas. Instead of this, you know, updating the formulas in the Excel, you can use the Excel VBA code to get the information, get the formulas and everything. For everything, we have a Excel VBA code. Very simple. You need to type worksheet function dot sum of this value. So here I'm going to attach this file. You can download it anytime. just you need to practice. That's, you know, also I'm going to attach the formulas also. Just for your reference, I am attaching this formula. So you can download and practice the formulas. It's very, very important. Just understand the basic formulas.